I'm doing things that I never thought I'd be able to do. Like, I never thought I'd be able to spin on my head, and now I can spin on my head, and that's just wild to me.
By day, Dr. Rachael Gunn is a lecturer at Sydney's Macquarie Uni.
Everyone, we're in week 7 now. Portfolio 1 due at the end of this week. Somehow they'll see me, something on TV or something on Instagram, and they'll go, wait, is this you? And that definitely distracts the class.
Let's go, Raygun!
Class over, Rachael becomes Raygun. Dancing is also part of her academic journey. Her PhD focused on breaking.
I was looking at what research there was in the field. There was a lot on rap, but there was very little on breaking.
Breaking had its origins among African American and Latino teens in New York City in the 1970s.
Rocksteady Crew, New York City Breakers, they're the ones that really were featured in all these big films and video clips and world tours, and what inspired countless people from around the world to start breaking.
Louis Napolan works for a stockbroker in Sydney's CBD.
There's a lot going on, transfers are coming in and out, so we're quite busy at the moment.
Yeah, fantastic.
While most of us dread the start of the week, Louis looks forward to it.
So on Mondays, I end up going to the Downing Centre. Different people turn up, but it's always a vibe when we practice there.
For hours on end, they practice for two big events on the weekend. First up, Destructive Steps Street Dance Festival.
One is our biggest street dance festival in Australia, so it has a bunch of genres, hip-hop, of course, breaking.
I entered the 101 B-Girl, and we had an international battle guest from Japan, and I won.
While Raygun didn't start breaking until her mid-20s, moves like this might pave her way to the 2024 Paris Olympics, the first time a dance sport has featured at the Games.
She's still on top, and I definitely think she's probably going to win.
Yeah, there is a chance that, yeah, I could be representing Australia. It would be an amazing opportunity and just something I never thought would happen.
But Rachael is even more excited for the next generation of B-boys and B-girls.
Already there's a lot more family support for people to get in breaking, because I know people of my generation and earlier, you know, their families were generally like, what are you doing? Why are you wasting your time with this? And as soon as it's been announced in the Olympics, suddenly people are asking questions about it. They're interested in how the training's going.
Can I get you to make some noise for B-boy Louis?
Tonight, Louis and Rachael are judges at the Red Bull BC One event in Sydney. The best B-boy and B-girl win a trip to Paris to represent Australia at the finals.
Judges, 3, 2, 1.
There's a lot of stuff that you need to master in breaking. That's why the top level breakers are just so strong and so hard to beat.
Last year's winners, Kid Tech and Holy Molly, are contenders again tonight.
B-Girl Holy Molly!
When it comes to the Oceania Olympic qualifiers later in the year, the Wollongong teenager will be Rachael's most formidable competition.
Definitely Raygun's probably number one, followed by Molly.
Both the defending champions were out of luck tonight. But both Louis and Rachael see a bright future for breaking in Australia.
I get really excited when I see more women get into breaking and feel like they can enter that space. It's a culture, it's a community, it's a sport, it's an art form, it's so many different things. If you have